Hello, welcome to Epic Kids Online. My name is Teacher Khadisha, and I'm really excited to spend this Sunday with you. Oh, but look, it looks like my shoe is untied. Do you know how to tie and untie your shoes? I remember how hard it was to learn when I was your age. How about we turn tying our shoes into a game? You ready? First, start with two strings. You cross the two, then you pull one through and pull it tight. Then you loop, you swoop, and you pull it through. Then we untie it. Let's do it again. Start with two, cross, pull one through, and tie it tight. Then you loop, and you swoop, and you pull it through. One more time. Untie the shoe. Start with two strings, cross, pull one through, tie it tight, loop, swoop, and you pull it through. Good job tying your shoes today. If you didn't get it the first time, don't worry. We all had to practice a lot to master this skill. So if at first you don't succeed, try again. Now, how does tying our shoes tie into our Bible story? Tying and untying our shoes are small jobs, but help us in a big way so we don't trip and fall. In our Bible story today, John the Baptist said, even though he was doing small jobs, someone greater than him was coming to help us all in a big way. John said he wasn't even good enough to untie this person's sandals. Do you know who John the Baptist was talking about? That's right, Jesus. Praise God for Jesus. Let's praise God and sing a worship song, and then we'll hear our Bible story.
I've carried a burden for too long on my own. I wasn't created to bear it alone. I hear your invitation to let it all go. Yeah, I see it now. I'm laying it down, and I know that I need you. I run to the Father, I fall into grace. I'm done with the hiding, no reason to wait. My heart needs a surgeon, my soul needs a friend. So I run to the Father again and again and again and again. Oh, 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 oh. You saw my condition, had a plan from the start. Your son for redemption, the price for my heart. And I don't have a context for that kind of love. I don't understand, I can't comprehend. All I know is I need you. I run to the Father, I fall into grace. Hiding, no reason to wait. My heart needs a surgeon, my soul needs a friend. So I run to the Father again and again and again and again. Oh, 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 oh.
Been in your sight
to life from death. And I feel this rush deep in my chest. Your mercy is calling out. Just as I am, you pull me in. All I know is I need you now. I run to the Father, I fall into grace. I'm done with the hiding, no reason to wait. My heart needs a surgeon, my soul needs a friend. So I run to the Father again and again. I run to the Father, I fall into grace. I'm done with the hiding, no reason to wait. My heart found a surgeon, my soul found a friend. So I run to the Father again and again and again and again. Oh, 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 again and again. Oh, 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 oh.
Hi friends, I'm Megan,
and I'm Jessie.
What are you doing with that cloth, Jessie?
I've been cleaning. My mom told me to wipe the dust off everything in our house.
Wow, that's a big job.
Yep, my mom and dad's friends who live far away are coming to stay at our house for a whole week. Mom and dad said everybody's got to pitch in to get things ready.
Nice. In today's Bible story, God gave a man named John the Baptist a job to do to get things ready for someone special to come.
Oh, did John the Baptist have to dust and clean?
No, John's job was to get people ready for Jesus. He told people to stop sinning and turn back to God. Listen to this story.
John the Baptist lived in the wilderness, far away from the city. His clothes were made out of camel's hair, and his belt was made of leather. When John was hungry, he ate locusts and wild honey. John began telling people, "Repent and be baptized. God's kingdom is coming. It is almost here."
"Who are you?" the people asked. John said, "I am not the Messiah." Many years before John was born, Isaiah the prophet said, "Someone is shouting in the wilderness. He says, 'Get ready for the Lord, make way for him.'" Isaiah had been talking about John. John had a very important job. He was supposed to get people ready for Jesus, the Messiah God promised.
People listened to John and they started to repent. They were sorry for their sins and asked God to forgive them. Then John baptized them in the Jordan River. John said, "Someone greater than me is coming. I am not good enough to even untie his sandals. I baptize you with water, but he will baptize you with God's Spirit."
Now Jesus was in the land of Galilee. He went to see John the Baptist at the Jordan River. Jesus asked John to baptize him. John was surprised. He didn't think he should baptize Jesus. John said, "I need you to baptize me." "Why do you want me to baptize you?" John only baptized people who were sorry for their sins. Jesus never sinned.
Jesus said, "Let me be baptized. God says this is the right thing to do." So John baptized Jesus. When Jesus came up from the water, the sky opened and Jesus saw God's Spirit coming down on him like a dove. Then God's voice came from heaven. "This is my son," the voice said. "I love him and I am very happy with him."
Jesus never did anything wrong, but he was baptized like sinners are baptized. Baptism reminds us that Jesus died and came back to life. People who know and love Jesus are baptized to show they are following Jesus.
Wow! In the Bible story today, Jesus showed us how he was obedient to God by getting baptized by John in the Jordan River. Today, when we believe in our heart that Jesus died and came back to life, we get baptized to show Jesus how much we love him and that we want to follow him to be just like him. This week, let's remember Jesus' baptism by acting out the scene with our toys. Use your plastic toys in a bin of water or in your bathtub to play out the baptism story. Remember, people would come to John to be baptized when they were sorry for their sins and wanted to be clean and live better. Then one day, Jesus came to John to be baptized, and John was surprised. He said, "It is you who should baptize me." But he baptized Jesus because that's what God wanted. When Jesus came out of the water, the Holy Spirit sat down on him like a dove, and we heard God spoke, and he said, "This is my son. I love him. I am very happy with him." And this is how John knew Jesus was the Son of God. Now let's pray. God, thank you for Jesus and that he obeyed you and was baptized by John. Help us to obey you like Jesus and share Jesus' story. Amen. Thank you for joining us. And as we go, we will sing a worship song to help you remember this week's memory verse, John 3:30. He must increase, but I must decrease. We hope to see you back next week on Epic Kids Online. Bye!